This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Migration to New Zealand began with Polynesian settlement in New Zealand, then uninhabited. About 1250 to 1280 European migration provided a major influx following the signing of the Treaty of Waitangi in 1840. Subsequent immigration has been chiefly from the British Isles, but also from continental Europe, the Pacific, America and Asia. Contents: 1. Polynesian settlement, 2. European settlement, 3. Migration from 1844. Post-World War II migration, 5. Introduction of points-based systems, 51. New migrant groups, 52. Recent years, 53. Other migrant quotas, 6. Contemporary developments in immigration policy, 61. Immigration Advisors Licensing Act 2007, 62. Immigration Act 2009, 63. Further developments, 7. Public opinion. 8. See also. 9. References. 10. Bibliography. 11. External links. Polynesian settlement. Polynesians in the South Pacific were the first to discover the landmass of New Zealand. Eastern Polynesian explorers had settled in New Zealand by approximately the 13th century CE, with most evidence pointing to an arrival date of about 1280. Their arrival gave rise to the Maori culture and the Maori language, both unique to New Zealand, although very closely related to analogues in other parts of Eastern Polynesia. Evidence from Wairau Bar and the Chatham Islands shows that the Polynesian colonists maintained many parts of their East Polynesian culture, such as burial customs, for at least 50 years. Especially strong resemblances link Maori to the languages and cultures of the Cook and Society Islands, which are regarded as the most likely places of origin. Moriori settled the Chatham Islands during the 15th century from SE South Island of New Zealand. European settlement due to New Zealand's geographic isolation. Several centuries passed before the next phase of settlement, the arrival of European. Only then did the original inhabitants need to distinguish themselves from the new arrivals, using the adjective Maori, which means ordinary or indigenous, which later became a noun. Although the term New Zealand native was common until about 1890, Maori thought of their tribe IWI as a nation in Neolithic times. There was no pan-Maori organization. Cook claimed New Zealand for Britain on his arrival in 1769. The establishment of British colonies in Australia from 1788 and the boom in whaling and sealing in the Southern Ocean brought many Europeans to the vicinity of New Zealand. With some deciding to settle, whalers and sealers were often itinerant, and the first real settlers were missionaries and traders in the Bay of Islands area from 1809. By 1830, there was a population of about 800 non-Maori, which included a total of about 200 runaway convicts and seamen who often married into the Maori community. The seamen often lived in New Zealand for a short time before joining another ship a few months later. In 1839, there were 1,100 Europeans living in the North Island. Regular outbreaks of extreme violence, mainly between Maori hapu, known as the Musket Wars, resulted in the deaths of between 20,000 and 50,000 Maori up until 1843. Violence against European shipping, cannibalism, and the lack of established law and order made settling in New Zealand a risky prospect. By the late 1830s, many Maori were nominally Christian and had freed many of the Maori slaves that had been captured during the Musket Wars. By this time, many Maori, especially in the north, could read and write Maori and to a lesser extent English. Migration from 1840, a poster of the Shah, Saville. The strong westerly winds that carried the clippers well south of South Africa and Australia. Ships would then head north once in the vicinity of New Zealand. The Glentanner migrant ship of 610 tons made 2 runs to New Zealand and several to Australia, carrying 400 ton of passengers and cargo. Travel time was about 3 to 3.5 months to New Zealand. Cargo carried on the Glentanner for New Zealand included coal, slate, lead sheet, wine, beer, cart components, salt, soap and passengers' personal goods. On the 1857 passage, the ship carried 163 official passengers, most of them government assisted. On the return trip, the ship carried a wool cargo worth £45,000. In the 1860s, discovery of gold started a gold rush in Otago. By 1860, more than 100,000 British and Irish settlers lived throughout New Zealand. The Otago Association actively recruited settlers from Scotland, creating a definite Scottish influence in that region, while the Canterbury Association recruited settlers from the south of of England, creating a definite English influence over that region in the 1860s. Most migrants settled in the South Island due to gold discoveries and the availability of flat grass-covered land for pastoral farming. The low number of Maori, about 2,000, and the absence of warfare gave the South Island many advantages. It was only when the New Zealand Wars ended that the North Island again became an attractive destination. In the 1870s, the MP Julius Vogel borrowed millions of pounds from Britain to help fund capital development such as a nationwide rail system, lighthouses, ports and bridges, and encouraged mass migration from Britain. By 1870, the non-Maori population reached over 250,000. Other smaller groups of settlers came from Germany, Scandinavia, and other parts of Europe, as well as from China and India, but British and Irish settlers made up the vast majority, and did so for the next 150 years. Plaque commemorating the first meeting of the Canterbury Association in Charing Cross, London. The association would go on to found Canterbury, New Zealand in 1850. Between 1881 and the 1920s, the New Zealand Parliament passed legislation that intended to limit Asiatic migration to New Zealand, and prevented Asians from naturalizing. In particular, the New Zealand government levied a poll tax on Chinese immigrants. Up until the 1930s, New Zealand finally abolished the poll tax in 1944. Large numbers of Dalmatians fled from the Austro-Hungarian Empire to settle in New Zealand. Around 1900, they settled mainly in West Auckland and often worked to establish vineyards and orchards, or worked on gum fields in Northland. An influx of Jewish refugees from Central Europe came in the 1930s. Many of the persons of Polish descent in New Zealand arrived as orphans via Siberia and Iran during World War II. Post-World War II migration, with the various agencies of the United Nations dealing with humanitarian efforts following the Second World War, New Zealand accepted about 5,000 refugees and displaced persons from Europe, and more than 1,100 Hungarians between 1956 and 1959. See refugee migration into New Zealand. The post-World War II immigration included more people from Greece, Italy, Poland and the former Yugoslavia. New Zealand limited immigration to those who would meet a labour shortage in New Zealand to encourage those to come. The government introduced free and assisted passages in 1947, a scheme expanded by the National Party administration in 1950. However, when it became clear that not enough skilled migrants would come from the British Isles alone, recruitment began in northern European countries. New Zealand signed a bilateral agreement for skilled migrants with the Netherlands, and a large number of Dutch immigrants arrived in New Zealand. Others came in the 1950s from Denmark, Germany, Switzerland and Austria to meet needs in specialized occupations. By the 1960s, the policy of excluding people based on nationality yielded a population overwhelmingly European in origin. By the mid-1960s, a desire for cheap unskilled labor led to ethnic diversification. In the 1950s and 1960s, New Zealand encouraged migrants from the South Pacific. The country had a large demand for unskilled labor in the manufacturing sector. As long as this demand continued, migration was accepted from the South Pacific, and many temporary workers overstayed their visas. From 1977 to 1980, dawn raids were carried out by police to remove overstayers. Most were Pacific Islanders. In May 2008, Massey University economist Dr. Greg Clydesdale released to the news media an extract of a report, Growing Pains, Evaluations and the Cost of Human Capital, which saw Pacific Islanders as forming an underclass. The report, written by Dr. Clydesdale for the Academy of World Business, Marketing Policy change even more than the previous Labour Party administration. This system resembled that of Canada, and came into effect in 1991. Effectively, the New Zealand Immigration Service ranks the qualities sought in the migrants and gives them a priority using a points-based scale. In 2010, the new Immigration Act replaced all existing protocols and procedures. The government published the results of an immigration review in December 2006. Regulations provide that immigrants must be of good character. New migrant groups, top 10 countries of birth of New Zealand residents, 2013 census, country number 96,441, 242. 37,299,094. Immigration from Asia. However, a study for residency program for foreign university students has mitigated this imbalance somewhat. By 2005, New Zealand accepted 60% of the applicants under the skilled, business category that awarded points for qualifications and work experience, or business experience and funds they had available. From 1 August 2007, NZD $25. Nearly 100,000 people were issued work permits to work in sectors ranging from IT to horticulture in the 2005-06 year. This compares with around 35,000 work permits issued in 1999-2000. Around 52,000 people were approved for permanent New Zealand residence in 2005-06. Over 60% were approved under the skilled or business categories. Other migrant quotas: New Zealand accepts 750 refugees per year mandated by the United Nations as part of the Pacific Access category. 650 citizens come from Fiji, Tuvalu, Kiribati, and Tonga. 1,100 Samoan citizens come under the Samoan quota scheme once resident. These people can apply to bring other family members to New Zealand under the family-sponsored stream. Any migrant accepted under these schemes receives permanent residency in New Zealand. On 13 June 2016, the government announced that the number of refugees which may be accepted will be raised to 1,000 per year. Contemporary developments in immigration policy. Immigration Advisors Licensing Act 2007, effective in New Zealand from 4 May 2007. The Immigration Advisors Licensing Act requires anyone providing immigration advice to be licensed. It also established the Immigration Advisors Authority to manage the licensing process, both in New Zealand and offshore. From 4 May 2009, it became mandatory for immigration advisors practicing in New Zealand to be licensed. The introduction of mandatory licensing for New Zealand-based immigration advisors was designed to protect migrants from unscrupulous operators and provide support for licensed advisors. The licensing managed by the Immigration Advisors Authority official website establishes and monitors industry standards and sets requirements for continued professional development as an independent body. The authority can prosecute unlicensed immigration advisors. Penalties include up to 7 years imprisonment and/or fines up to $100,000 New Zealand for offenders, as well as the possibility of court-ordered reparation payments. It can refer complaints made against licensed advisors to an independent tribunal. Immigration advisors who work offshore but give advice about New Zealand immigration matters must obtain a license by 4 May 2010. The Immigration Advisors Authority does not handle immigration applications or inquiries. These are managed by Immigration New Zealand. Immigration Act 2009. Statements by the government in the mid-2000s emphasized that New Zealand must compete for its share of skilled and talented migrants, and David Cunliffe, the former immigration minister, has argued that New Zealand was in a global race for talent and we must win our share. With this in mind, a bill over 400 pages long was prepared, which was sent to Parliament in April 2007. It follows a review of the Immigration Act. The bill aims to make the process more efficient, and achieves this by giving more power to immigration officers. Rights of appeal were to be streamlined into a single appeal tribunal. Furthermore, any involvement of the Human Rights Commission in matters of immigration to New Zealand would be removed. Part 11, Clause 350. The new Immigration Act, which passed into law in 2009 replacing the 1987 Act, is aimed to enhance border security and improve the efficiency of the immigration services. Key aspects of the new act include the ability to use biometrics, a new refugee and protection system, a single independent appeals tribunal, and a universal visa system. Further developments: as of March 2012, a draft paper leaked to the New Zealand Labour Party shows Immigration New Zealand is planning to create a two-tier system which will favour wealthy immigrants over poor ones who speak little or no English. This means that applications from parents sponsored by their higher income children, or those who bring a guaranteed income or funds, would be processed faster than other applications. Public opinion: as in most other countries, immigration is a highly contentious issue and has provoked fierce debate from time to time in New Zealand. The political party New Zealand First has frequently criticized immigration on economic, social and cultural grounds. New Zealand First leader Winston Peters has on several occasions characterized the rate of Asian immigration into New Zealand as too high. In 2004, he stated, "We are being dragged into the status of an Asian colony and it is time that New Zealanders were placed first in their own country." On 26 April 2005, he said, "Maori will be disturbed to know that in 17 years' time they will be outnumbered by Asians in New Zealand," an estimate disputed by Statistics New Zealand. The Government Statistics Bureau. Peters quickly rebutted that Statistics New Zealand has underestimated the growth rate of the Asian community in the past. In April 2008, Deputy New Zealand First Party leader Peter Brown drew widespread praise after voicing similar views and expressing concern at the increase in New Zealand's ethnic Asian population. "We are going to flood this country with Asian people with no idea what we are going to do with them when they come here. The matter is serious. If we continue this open-door policy, there is real danger we will be inundated with people who have no intention of integrating into our society. The greater the number, the greater the risk they will form their own mini-societies to the detriment of integration, and that will lead to division, friction and resentment. See also demographics of New Zealand. Europeans in Oceania, Chinese immigration to New Zealand. References: http://wawatagon/profiles/historianarthdhtml Germans, first arrivals from the Te Era Encyclopedia of New Zealand. Glentanner B. Lansley, Dorney Publishing, Invercargill 2013. History of Immigration 1840-1852. December 2006. Retrieved 6 November 2007. 2012. King, M. 2003, The Penguin History of New Zealand, Penguin, Auckland Macmillan, K. 2006, Immigration Policy, pg. 639-650 in New Zealand Government and Politics, Ed R. Miller, AUP History of Immigration at Te Era Encyclopedia of New Zealand. News release from Caritas NZ. External links: Immigration New Zealand, Immigration Advisors Authority, New Zealand Immigration Statistics, VE Immigration to New Zealand from Africa, Africans, South Africans from the Americas, Americans, Canadians from Asia, Arabs, Cambodians, Chinese, Filipinos, Indians, Indonesians, Iranian, Iraqis, Japanese, Jews, Koreans, Malaysians, Nepalis, Pakistanis, Sri Lankans, Thais, Turkish, Vietnamese from Europe, Albanian, Austrian, British, English, Scottish, Welsh, Croatian, Danish, Dutch, Finnish, French, German, Greek, Hungarian, Icelandic, Irish, Italian, Norwegian, Polish, Portuguese, Russian, Serbian, Spanish, Swedish, Ukrainian, Oceania, Australian, Samoan. See also refugee migration into New Zealand, immigration New Zealand, VE New Zealand. History timeline, military history, Treaty of Waitangi, New Zealand Wars, Women's Suffrage, New Zealand and Antarctica Colony, Dominion, Independence, Geography, Biodiversity, Caves, Earthquakes, Environment, Geology, Islands, North Island, South Island, Lakes, Marine Reserves, National Parks, Rivers, Time Zones, Towns, Cities, Auckland, Largest, Christchurch, Dunedin, Hamilton, Invercargill, New Plymouth, Napier, Hastings, Nelson, Palmerston North, Rotorua, Tauranga, Wellington, Capital, Politics, Constitution, Elections, Flag Debate, Foreign Relations, Government, Cabinet, Prime Minister, Governor General, Human Rights, LGBT Law, Supreme Court, Chief Justice, Enforcement, Military, Constitutional Advisory Panel, Monarchy, Parliament, Political Parties, Economy, Agriculture, Companies, Energy, Rogernomics, Taxation, Telecommunications, Tourism, Transport, Society, Citizenship, Crime, Demographics, Education, Immigration, Languages, Maori, New Zealand, English, New Zealand, Sign Language, LGBT People, Kiwi, Maori Culture, Art, Cinema, Cuisine, Literature, Maori Culture, Media, Music, Public Holidays, Religion, Sport, Outline, Book, Category, Portal, VE Immigration to Oceania, Sovereign States, Australia, Federated States of Micronesia, Fiji, Kiribati, Marshall Islands, Nauru, New Zealand, Palau, Papua New Guinea, Samoa, Solomon Islands, Tonga, Tuvalu, Vanuatu, Associated States of New Zealand, Cook Islands, Niue, Dependencies and Other Territories, American Samoa, Christmas Island, Cocos Keeling Islands, Easter Island, French Polynesia, Guam, Hawaii, New Caledonia, Norfolk Island, Northern Mariana Islands, Pitcairn Islands, Tokelau, Wallace and Futuna.